window at the world outside, wondering will mother survive, hoping that mankind will stop abusing her sometime. After all, there's only just the two of us, and here we are still fighting for our lives, watching all of history repeat itself time after time. I'm just a dreamer, a dreamer for a week.
The sun go down like every one of us. I'm hoping that the dawn will bring us light, a better place for those who will come in this time. I'm just a dreamer, a dream my life away. I'm just a dreamer who dreams of better days. Your higher power may be God or Jesus Christ. It doesn't really matter much to me. Without each other's help,
it would be nice if we could live as one. When will all this anger, hate, and bigotry be gone? I'm just a dreamer, I dream my life away. Today
Hi guys, I just wanted to play that song. It's deep to me, and I love deep. So, So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give some answers right now. I have an appointment at 1 o'clock, but I do want to at least answer some. I know you guys have a lot of questions. I want to thank you for joining. I have it cocked a little bit. For some reason, I'm not seeing questions. This really is not about questions right now. Gotten a chance to answer the post that I did on colors. And there's two posts, if you check my timeline. One for health and another one was asked for colors for in this time of life, what kind of direction you're seeking that you're confused about, you know. A lot of people don't know who I am. I'm very in-depth type of person. You know, what you think is very important right now, you're stressing yourself about, could be not what is actually going on with you. So what I'm doing is I love the healer in me. And, you know, to be able to help another person, it actually helps me, you know, and that's why I love what I do. Excuse the nerd look. I also want to thank everyone watching Ghost of Shepherdstown. You guys rock. Don't forget to go to Destination America. They have a Facebook page. Let them know how you feel about it. You want to see more of it. I'm very proud to be even part of this show. I'm actually looking for the post. Sorry, guys. You know, a lot of readers, you know, we don't get confirmation or testimonials on how your reading turned out or how a few months later it was like, oh my God, Lorie, you're right, you know. And it's not just about me. It's all of us readers. There are seers. There's prophets. There are intuitives. There's psychics, there's mediums. I mean, we all do some type of a work to help people, and that's why you're drawn to particular people. It's almost like the wolf pack. We all our souls know each other, and we're drawn to that particular person. Like I know you, but I don't know where I know you from. Well, that's because our souls know each other, you know. And humans, they have the mind of where they limit themselves on what they want to remember. Still looking, guys. Sorry. Oh, there it is. Okay. It's the post that I had August 8th at 12:06 a.m. I said, I want to do something. I wish for you to pick one, and I mean one color. I want to use the difference of the colors as an aura chart in a different way of seeing in a person. Remember, I'm not like others. What I am doing is once you chose a color, I will see what is actually your pain or what could be stopping you with something you deal with. Be nice and pick only one. Please have some patience because I'm going to write the color meanings and do because you're drawn to the red means you're mad. So, you know, it's just like a dream. You know, we dream that we're at a lake and one of our children got into a raft and, you know, the child disappeared on you. Doesn't mean that that child drowned or died. It means that some of us have issues on letting go of our children or our parents or moving forward from a loved one or a husband or a wife or a girlfriend or a boyfriend. You know, we have an issue of feeling that once that person's in our life, We own them. We don't own anything. Not our children, not our home, not our cars, not our job, not our parents. We're here to do our job, and that is to move on in love. You stay in their life. You know, there's a lot of distance in family here lately that I've noticed, and including mine. You know, to the point where you don't feel like you're part of that family anymore. But that's not true. We have differences, and just because you're born in that same family doesn't mean that we all have to be the same or see the same. You know, there's a lot of readings that I've been doing, in reading healings, and that's what I love, my hour readings, because I offer that healing in that reading, is that I've noticed that parents are starting to deal with children are getting mouthy or rebellion, or, and they're 40 years old, they're 16 years old, they're old enough to know better. But the thing is that you have to learn to get close to that child, you know, to not be feeling like they feel that you're trying to, you know, control their life, is cutting that cord between you and that child, or you and that husband, or you and that parent, or you and that animal, so that way you both have your own mind to be able to know what you want. You know, I and it sounds mean, I'm a daddy's girl. My dad passed away in 06, and I felt like I could not grow up at 40 years old until my dad died. And that is bad. That's sad, but you know what? I felt that I was obligated to make him feel he's still young. And it's not up to us to do that. And it took me a long time to realize that. That, you know, he chose my first boyfriend. He chose my first husband. I mean, it was like I never had a life. And when we do this to our children or our husband or our wife or our parents, you're a puppet, and we don't want to be a puppet. All right, so what I'm going to do is, if you guys can see that, let's see if I can get them all in. Okay. The first one is a red. And this one is going to be a healing type of thing. So you can go back to August 8th on my timeline and look at your answers or what color you chose. It's not your best color. It's the color that was drawn to you. The red is those that are dealing with anxiety. Anxiety. So anxiety to me is someone that is basically living in a place where they're not comfortable. They're miserable in their own bed. They're feeling like there's something missing. You have to change it yourself. You cannot look on someone else to do this for you. We have to do it ourselves. We're born alone, we die alone, and the thing is, we have to think alone. You know, a lot of people feel that they need a mate to fulfill them. No, you don't. Because if that's the only thing that you're looking for in a relationship, honey, you're going to become the mother or the father of this person. Stop. That's most of the time our healers. Healers always draw in the broken. Whatever is in you that's in another, you're going to draw it until you see it within yourself. Second one, orange. Orange means that you're blind. To me, and remember, this is my sight. I'm not a doctor. I'm not a lawyer. I'm not degreed in, you know, psychology. I do my gift because I believe in it. I love it, and I get channeled through. So if you see lights flickering all over the place, those are my guides. Those are my guardians. Those are the light within me opening up to hear what you need to hear that you refuse to hear. The orange is you're blind, means that something's going on in your life that you're refusing to see. You're drinking more, you're smoking more, you're depressed more. This is the first signs. It needs to be changed. Stop denying it. Stop feeling like if you walk away from it, you're not going to have it again. When an abused person grows up and still is being abused, the thing is, you're not seeing your own self or self-love. You've got to find it. You've got to find it. Been there, done that, still do it sometimes. Yellow. Yellow is my favorite color, but in this point, this is the healing type where you're not seeing what needs to be seen. So yellow would be the lower back issues. Lower back issues means that it's connected to your buttocks and your legs. So when it happens like that, and you're chosen yellow, means that you're supposed to be doing something, but you're fearing it. Don't fear it. Sometimes it's okay to fail, but as long as you've tried, you're going to succeed in it. Light green, I call it lime green. Lime green means that you're not listening. You're not listening to something around you. It could be verbal abuse. It could be something that you know it's driving you nuts and you know about it. Thing is if you feel that you're protecting that particular person or persons, you're actually hurting yourself. So you're withholding energy of this, a feeling that it needs to be suppressed. So if you have to write it down to release it, do it. But if you feel that you can go to one particular person or go to that person and open up and say, look, I know what's going on. I hear what's going on. I'm not blind. I'm here for you. But this is needs to be told. This one is a very deep, dark green. This one's in the middle, below the orange. This one's telling me the mouth. Mouth means your opinion. You're opinionated. It means that you're speaking sometimes out of your butt. It means that you're wasting your time on some things that you think that people need to hear. Sometimes it's okay to be quiet and move forward with what you know that needs to be done. Dark green, I call it forest green. This is to do with your feet. Feet means that you're not releasing energy as far as it's time to go, it's time to change, it's time to think for yourself. Then you have the teal green, that would be over here. Excuse my nails, I just took them off. This one's to do with the hands. The teal green's telling me the hands means that you're afraid to do something, or you're afraid to write something down because you're fearing your own self. So when you're writing down, use a pencil because it's close to the Mother's Earth. And when you do that, you're releasing stress. And sometimes you're fearing what other people think. Don't fear it. The teal green's telling me that maybe it's time to start writing your bio or your feelings or sending that Dear John or my 1 o'clock appointment. All right, then we're going to do the bright blue. The bright blue usually I do with the Archangel Michael. Now, this one here is actually above your top chakra. That means that you're holding on to things too tight from the past. You need to let go of that. Sometimes forgiving it, not just for you or them, but for you. So that way they're not controlling your nows. So the top chakra is your memory to me. Then I'm going to go to the last one, and that's a purple. Purple means healing. You have to heal. Stop worrying about everything around you. Stop worrying about, does this person like me, or should I move, or should this relationship? You're stressing yourself. Purple is a healing sensation to the point of, you know, your heart. So you need to stop worrying and just jump to it. Just go for it. Believe in it. And who cares if you get a no or what, if something that you don't want to hear? Put your thumb in your mouth and get over it. There's more fish in the sea. Sometimes what we want is not good for us, and that's why we don't get it. All right? So on this live feed, I want you to let me know if I'm on point, it makes sense. Again, let me know what the answers is that came forth, how you feel about it. All right, I'll see you guys again in a couple hours. God bless.